Thank you, sir. I am Dr. Abhishek Anand, and I am basically a retina surgeon who is also doing some anterior segment. So all the question would be directed to Pranav sir, Sujit sir, and Suhas sir. So let's talk about management. So when I want to speak about PCR, this is the disclaimer that we should all understand. PCR is a known complication. It can happen in best of hands at any point of cataract surgery. Although successful implantation of IOL in bag or sulcus with complete removal of lenticular and vitreous gel should be our goal in the same setting. Many alternative techniques currently exist, which I personally can vouch for, gives almost same results as an uncomplicated phaco. Badly managed PCR should be best avoided. So with this disclaimer, I would like to continue. So what is PCR? PCR is any breach in continuity of the posterior capsule, whether congenital, traumatic, spontaneous, or intrasurgical. And today we are going to focus more on, since it's a IC on phaco mantra, so we are more focusing on PCR during intrasurgical, especially phaco. So the incidence is around 1 to 4%. What is the best management? Prevention is the best management. So all the predisposing factors, and there are a lot of persons who are here sitting. I think there are a lot of they must be having their own institutes, and they must be associated with a lot of medical colleges. We must identify the predisposing factors. We all know it. We have to just identify it and sort out who is going to do that case. That case should be done by an experienced person and not by a person who is in its learning phase. So prevention is the best management. Identify and strategize. What are the mechanisms? And nothing can be done if you don't understand the mechanism of PCR. We have to understand the mechanism, how PCR is created in different steps. And if we learn only then only we can prevent it. So wound construction, leaky wounds, like if you made a 2.8, 3.2 incision and you are using a 2.8 or 2.2 phaco, it will keep swelling. So that can lead to a PCR. Anterior, nothing more. We all know about CCC. If you have extended rexus, just cut it. Don't try to pull it like if somebody is trying to do it. Hydrodissection, you don't have to push too much fluid. It might go to a blowout. There are some innate weakness like polar cataracts. Nuclear management, we should be careful while we are doing genular disinsertion. Taking the, we can have a capsular rip while we are trying to do phaco if we are very close to the capsule margin. And during irrigation and aspiration, use of excessive vacuum, orientation of the port of aspirating port, not we are too close to the capsule, we are not using the right, not using retroillumination and looking, if, especially during capsular pollice. And during IOL implantation, we can have a sudden jerky injection of the IOL, or we are not pushed too much viscoelastics, and the capsular bag is too shallow. And what is important is these are the high risk periods, and the most of the PCR happen during this. So maintain extra caution during a high-risk period, especially when we are learning our learning curve. In any case, even if PCR occurs early identification can be a game changer. So if we continue doing phaco emulsification without identifying, it might totally change the management strategy. So early identification is one of the main thing that we have a PCR, you have to identify early. And the signs are sudden deepening, sudden transitory appearance of a clear red reflex, inability to rotate a previously mobile nucleus, excessive lateral mobility or displacement of the nucleus and loss of nucleus followability, excessive tipping of one pole of the nucleus, and partial descent of the nucleus into the anterior vitreous space. So if we identify it early, the management can change totally, dramatically. What are the goals of management of any PCR? To avoid posterior dislocation of the nucleus, nuclear fragments, epinucleus, or cortical matter into the vitreous cavity. Prevent any damage to the cornea. And this is very important. Of all the things which are modifiable, once we have a permanent corneal endothelial damage, we have excessive loss of endothelial cells, the whole management can change drastically. So prevention of endothelial damage during cornea, that is one of the most important things that we have to take care of, because it might lead to totally another paradigm shift in management. Prevent enlargement of tear, prevent damage to the capsular rexus. This is also very important. Like when we are managing a case of PCR, we should not enlarge, like we should preserve, try to preserve the sulcus. Minimize size of vitrectomy, avoid traction, remove leftover cortex, because if you have some cortical, we all know the nuclear part doesn't cause that much inflammation postoperatively. While if you have the cortical remnant, that might cause a lot of long-term inflammation. Maintain the wound size and proper positioning of the PCR. And your management strategy depends on the extent of PCT. intactness of the hyoid phase, location of the nucleus, whether dislodged into the vitreous cavity, availability of equipment, vitreous cutter, you have access to retina surgeon, you don't have access to retina surgeon, availability of alternative IOLs, knowledge about anterior vitrectomy, and availability of VR surgeon, it all depends. So every case differs, every situation differs, and where you are operating determines how you're going to manage PCR. There's always an urge to withdraw. Whenever you have a PCR, you always have an urge to withdraw the instruments. Rapid removal of instruments should be avoided. We all know we have an anterior compartment and a posterior compartment. The way is to maintain the pressure equivalent between the two compartments. If you don't if you have a pressure of high pressure in the posterior compartment with low pressure, whole of the vitreous will start coming into the anterior compartment. This will enlarge the PCR. So the idea should be to maintain. So whenever you withdraw the instruments, if you have a PCR, just maintain at the infusion. Just maintain the infusion. Put some viscoelastic, maintain the anterior chamber. You have a pressure, equipressure between the two chambers, and then you withdraw the instruments. So what are the basic principles of PCR management? Dispersive viscoelastic management should be injected to plug the posterior capsule tear. Nuclear material is moved into the anterior chamber with a spatula and emulsified with a short burst. Low bottle height, low flow rate, and high and low ultrasound. Attempts to retrieval of dislocated nucleus carrying high risk of creating peripheral tears. So no fishing at all. Removal of the remaining cortical micro should be attempted with preservation of the anterior and posterior capsule. Anterior vitrectomy should be performed so as to allow closure of the wound without vitreous incarceration. Secondary removal of dislocated nucleus through three-fourth paraphysmal effect is displaced posteriorly. Anterior vitrectomy, use of maximum possible cutting rate, lowest vacuum and flow rates, reduce traction on the retina. So these are the basic principles. So basically what you want to do, if you look at the diagram number two, so we have a PCR and the vitreous is bulging into the anterior chamber. So basically we have put the vitreous cutter down into the through the PCR gape, which we have, and we keep the mouth of the vitrectomy cutter forced up. So what we are doing is that we are pushing the prolapsed vitreous from the anterior chamber into the posterior space, and we keep it constant. There I've seen a lot of persons trying to follow the vitreous. What vitreous just follows what you are following. So let's see some real life situation. And there are some videos contributed to me by, and this is a Dr. Salas video. So basically, so we are here in this case, we have a PCR. We can see that there we have a PCR. So now let's look at the left hand. So in the left hand, what we have a vertical PCR, and what he is doing is that he is going to inject viscoelastics before we go. The video is not playing. Can you come to
anyway, we are also running short of time, Dr. Abhishek, so.
I'll just finish some important videos. Now this is another case in which now this is something which happens and you zoom. So where you can see just now here, there is an abnormal deepening of something has happened. Now this point, the surgeon doesn't stop. He keeps on continuing. And so the PCI enlarges. First nuclear fragment has fallen. So he tries to do it fast. Second nuclear fragment has fallen. And now the third nuclear fragment has fallen. So now you don't have to do much. Implant the IOL and send us to us. So that is best strategy. So this is the light. The only thing that which I feel that should be emphasized in this point is that if you see when the surgeon has closed the wound in the last, so he has hydrated, closed the wound, but he has not put a suture in the main port. That should be done. Should be sutured. Secondly, he didn't do adequate anterior vitrectomy. That should have been done. Because post-operatively, it will lead to how much clarity I can see. It will also have, there is no high pressure, as well as clearing of the viscoelastics. Now, not
and
always.
Thirdly, he should have put multi-piece lens here.
Multi-piece lens.
Yeah.
So and this case, not always this. This is a video by Dr. Nagendra, sir. So what he does that he notices the PCR, early PCR recognition. He proceeds with prolapse the nucleus into the anterior chamber, puts an IOL scaffold. It's this, also in this case, he should have put a multi-piece IOL. and then with adequate caution, low phaco power, taking care of the corneal endothelium, we can continue and complete the, there is no mechanism of forwarding the video. And we could safely complete the whole phaco. He did stain in this video, I would not able to, but he did stain for the vitreous. Can I continue for another one or two videos?
We already reached out and have already crossed time.
This is a series of complications that created.
Yeah, but unfortunately, so, we have limited, you know, we have to hand over the session.
This video, so this person is a person who is learning phaco. So he tries to do in, you know, he have the high thing that I can do in hard cataracts. So he tries to do, and now the pupil has become small. So rightly so, oh my God. This video, and this was another video in which there was a rent during the irrigation and aspiration. So to conclude, identify the presence of predisposing factors and appropriate modification of the surgical plan. That is one of the most important things that can prevent a PCR. Intra-op, do not panic. If PCR occurs, don't shout on your colleagues or don't shout on your persons who are assisting. Be silent. Have a calm mind. Early recognition and treatment of capsular tear and vitreous loss prevents serious complications and improves postoperative outcome. Take time to ponder. Take 1 or 2 minutes. Think what is the best strategy for the patient. In an event, in case of doubts, calling your person who are standing outside or your colleagues, even if I might say this is not official, but even asking your experienced assistant that what should be, that can give you some valuable inputs. Take help of retina colleagues whenever required. And most importantly, which we miss, discuss PCR with your patient post-operatively and explain the intraoperative and future management strategy. Thank you.